Yes, dear children, now I will be teaching you about resource geopolitics. If you understand the concept of resource geopolitics, you know resources are a cause of politics. Because what are resources? Resources are the things because of which you can grow, you can become rich. Countries need resources. If you go back in history, beyond the level of your book, if you see the First World War, the Second World War, the colonization, why did it take place? It took place because all these countries wanted resources. Why did the Second World War take place? The Second World War took place because the world was already divided between the European countries and there was nothing more left to win. So, European countries started fighting with each other and the Second World War took place. The same was the reason for First World War. When Hitler wanted it, Second World War took place. So, resources have been a cause of politics always. And with this thought in mind, let us look at this topic and what do we see? It says, resource geopolitics is all about who gets what, when, where and why. So, again, let's look at it again. Who, what, when, where and how. So, everybody is interested. And to get resources. If you look at resources, the most beautiful resource that the world has is petroleum. Because petroleum has got energy. And energy, because of that, everybody wants that they may have petrol. If you see, oil has been a very important resource. And what does it lead to? It leads to rivalries. It leads to interstate rivalries. And what happens is the relationship of trade, war and power, they are all related to resource geopolitics. And if you see that every country wants that they may be able to get resources, and you see the book also is reflecting the same thing, that why did the First World War take place? Why did the Second World War take place? It was all because of resources. Everybody wanted more. Why did Russia enter the First World War? Because Russia thought, I will be able to get some more areas. But that did not happen. The Cold War and throughout the Cold War, industrialized nations and North adopted methods to ensure steady flow of resources. So all the countries want that their country may be able to have more and more petroleum and other things. And what do? To get this, they use military force and sea lanes of communication. What are sea lanes of communications? The way of through the sea lanes of communication, minerals and can easily reach your areas. Hai na? So, stockpiling of resources is being done. And what do they want? That that countries which are favorable to them should be in command. If you look at this picture that you have, here it says how neo-colonialism works. If you see in this picture, it says, now that we have destroyed your country, you can pay the bill to rebuild it. So what are they telling? One man is talking, the man who is talking is also holding a gun. This means the person who is being asked to make an agreement is under threat of his own life. So he has no option to choose. We accept natural resources like oil as payment. So here you can see, again the gun is still pointing. So the one who is alive has to agree. So this is what it is. It and what is written above it? No exit. There is no other way out. So what do you see in resource politics? Always the countries with resources have been able to control the world through the resources that they have. And what do we find? That the Western countries are controlling the oil. If you see, many a times the war that take place in the Gulf region, anything happens in Gulf region, America is very interested. When whole Tibet went to China, nobody was interested because Tibet had no minerals. When Kuwait was attacked, America was so hurt. Kuwait's freedom was important. Why? Because Kuwait had got If Saddam Hussein could have controlled Kuwait or as well as Iraq, then he would have been able to have 50% of the world oil, and he would have become the most richest person. And that is why the whole world was against this. So you can see a new world order began at that time. So here you can see that everybody wants that the Gulf may be under their control. The global economy relies on oil. Why? Because it is portable and is indispensable fuel. That means your cars cannot run without oil. Your motors cannot run without oil. Because the history of petroleum is also the history of war and struggle. Understood? And what does it say? That 30% of the global production is coming from Central Asia, West Asia, Gulf region, which have got 30% of the oil resource, and 64% of the planet's known reserves are also with them. And further you can see, it says that there is in Saudi Arabia again you will see a lot of oil is there. It says has quarter of the world's total reserves. Quarter means 1/4 of the total world's reserves. And Iraq reserves are second only to Saudi Arabia. And United States, Japan, India are the main consumers who are located very far, but they are influenced. Why? Because why are they influenced? Because they need that oil. And what do the now we look at water. See, oil is most important for us, but in countries where water is a shortage, like water is also very important. So let us look at water. And with this, in the next page, it says that just like in India and Pakistan, 20% of water of Indus we can share, rest of the water goes to Pakistan. When it comes to China and India, China has built a dam because it did not even heed to take us into any discussion, and they built a dam because they are at the upper level, the water is coming from their side. So that way the upper riparian states, means the states which are at the higher level of the river, they are the upper riparian states. So they may build their dams and cause problem for the people who are living in the lower riparian states. What was happening was there was a violence that took place. What was happening was that countries near to Israel, they were trying to reduce the water in Israel. And if you see example of violence, including those of Israel, Syria, Jordan in 1950s and 60s, over the attempt by each side to divert water from Jordan and Yarmouk rivers, and more recently threat between Turkey, Syria and Iraq over construction of dam on Euphrates rivers. A number of studies show that countries that share river, and many countries do share rivers, are involved in military conflict with each other. So here you can see the whole wars are taking place. Why? Because the countries which are above have tried to control the water. So with this we conclude this topic. Thank you.